Trillionaire from space. Can asteroid mining create the world's first trillionaire? Okay, I know you're thinking, it may seem like a far-fetched idea, but asteroid mining has proven to be possible. This isn't some new plan that everyone is so skeptical to consider. This idea has been around since the 1970s, and organizations like NASA have been trying to achieve this. And let me just say that if that idea is turned into a reality, the world's trillionaire will come to be. You heard it here first, folks. Oh, who am I kidding? Many influential people before me have said that asteroid mining will create the first ever trillionaire. Take Neil deGrasse Tyson, for example. Among other titles, he is an American astrophysicist. And in one interview, he himself said that the universe we are in contains limitless energy and resources. And the very first person to mine these resources will be the first trillionaire in the world. So now that people have the idea on how to become the first trillionaire, the questions that need to be answered are, how does this asteroid mining work? How much will it cost us? And how can we profit from it? But before I answer those big questions, let us start with the smaller ones. Let's figure out why asteroids are such a big deal in the first place. What exactly are they? And what do they have that we desperately need? Think of it this way. Asteroids are leftovers from the creation of our solar system that occurred 4.6 billion years ago. When the solar system collided, massive groups of dust particles scattered and grouped themselves into what we call planetesimals. And asteroids are one of those large clumps of dust particles. It comes in a variety of shapes and sizes. Some grow big enough to form new planets, and most of them just remain as asteroids, revolving around the sun in elliptical orbits. And there are even other asteroids that have been captured by a planet's gravity, resulting in them to become moons. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. The asteroids out there are filled with trillions of dollars worth of materials and precious metals. And the best thing about this whole ordeal is that asteroids are much closer to Earth than you think. In fact, there's a complete package of asteroids in an area called Near-Earth Objects, or NEOs. Meteoroids, asteroids, or comets, depending on size, composition, and orbit. Since we are running out of rare metal and other resources, companies from all over the world are revisiting the possibility of sourcing these said materials from outer space. But since this is all about asteroid mining, let's focus on asteroids, shall we? These irregular-shaped asteroids can be as long as 583 miles, or maybe just a meter or two. But despite their small size, these asteroids can be dangerous, especially if they stray away from the asteroid belt and enter our atmosphere at high speeds. Now, let's answer one of the big questions. How does asteroid mining work? The first step in mining an asteroid is to, of course, find one that promises a good return on investment. Because you see, there are three types of asteroids out there. The C-type, or chondrite, which consists of clay and silicate rocks, the S-types, or stony asteroids, which are made up of silicate materials and nickel iron, and lastly, the M-types, which are metallic ones. Now that we've figured out which asteroids to look for, all we need to do now is to get a closer look to it and see if it's actually the right asteroid. We need to check if it really contains the metal or resources that we need. And for that to happen, we would need a spacecraft to go analyze the asteroid for us. It's a tricky task since asteroids are too small to have appreciable gravity, so in order for our spacecraft to do its thing, we need it to securely drill itself on the asteroid before analyzing any water or metal contents. And if it hits the jackpot, well, this is where the digging starts. It sounds easy when it's coming out of my mouth, but don't get your hopes up. Asteroid mining is actually really, really hard to accomplish, but not impossible. There are still a lot of things we need to do and have in order to mine asteroids, and one significant factor is money. Billions and billions of them. Creating a spacecraft that accommodates asteroid mining will undoubtedly be costly, especially when the time comes wherein we're launching it to space and bringing the mined resources back. It would empty up our pockets before we can even say asteroid. Today, sending a rocket to the moon cost us $450 million. And that's just until the moon. Asteroids are way further out there, and they're incredibly challenging considering that they are on constant move. Plus, they don't have their own gravity that our rocket can settle into. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, or JAXA, has actually executed the most successful missions to retrieve materials from asteroids so far using the Hayabusa spacecraft, which cost them roughly $100 million. But it's not what you think. They didn't mine for metal or drill itself on the asteroid since it wasn't equipped for that. In fact, it encountered many difficulties in the midst of its mission. It was, however, successful in retrieving some dust particles that were very useful for more in-depth studies. The latest technology we've seen sent to space is NASA's Perseverance rover. Do you guys know where it is? It's on Mars! Now guess how much it cost them? Around $3 billion! That's a whole load of money! But it sure will be worth it since scientists believe that asteroids might be made up of as much as 30% metal in the form of iron-nickel cobalt and platinum group alloy. With hundreds of thousands of these materials now in our grasp, it will not only make our economy flourish, but it can also revolutionize space exploration. Since water is one of the resources we can get from asteroids, scientists plan to use this for rocket fuel. Another plan of theirs is to set up a fuel station in low Earth orbit and near the asteroid belt so the spacecraft can stop by as they explore our universe. With space stations and maneuverable rockets, we can explore and grow to be a more advanced beings. With this knowledge, we won't be needing to ruin our planet even more. But as of now, all of these are plans or ideas saved for later. We still need to upgrade our technologies and science before we can even get that far, and for that to happen, we need money. Currently, no company is willing to spend billions of dollars on this venture that requires a whole lot of science and technology, and I don't blame them. It is pretty complex and very risky. May not happen today, but I guarantee that someday, the future generation will be using water, metals, or rocks from space. Since the global demand for technology and critical metals is constantly increasing. So if it won't happen now, it must happen soon for our world to thrive. We may encounter many obstacles and difficulties before we reach there, but if the result is our Earth growing trees instead of holes being dug, then so be it. We will get there. But tell me, what do you guys think about all these? What are your thoughts on asteroid mining? When do you think it'll most likely happen? Do you even think it's possible? Or do you think we're getting too ahead of ourselves? Tell us everything in the comment section below. I would love to hear what you think. That's it for today's video. Until next time!